What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Today, we got the Super Bowl, but first, I'm going to let you guys listen to the Tony Bruno Show from the week of the AFC and NFC Championship game. I'm one of the only guys that uploads Madden PS2 content, of course, ever since Madden, I think 04 or 05, I believe maybe 05, they had the Tony Bruno Show. So I'm going to let you guys listen to it, and then we'll jump into the Super Bowl. Let's get it.
Live from Silicon Valley, it's time for the EA Radio Show with host Tony Bruno. I'm your host, Tony Bruno, and what a weekend of football we've got. Four teams left in the pool. When the games are over, two will have a chance to play for the Super Bowl. This is where it's at. There is information aplenty coming your way. You don't want to miss it, so don't go anywhere. Stay tuned. It's time for what you've all anxiously been awaiting, the EA Sports Question of the Day. Got some place kicker trivia for you. From 1994 to 2003, this player led the NFL in total number of field goals made. Tell me who it is. All right, we have someone on the line now who thinks they know the answer to the question of the day. Which kicker led the NFL in total field goals from 1994 to 2003?
Tony, it's always someone that you wouldn't suspect, you know? That's why I think it's Doug Bryan.
Sorry, you're wide right on this one. We'll grab a line now and talk to the fans. See if one of them knows who the most prolific kicker was from 1994 to 2003.
Tony, I'm going to go with the kicker on my favorite team, Jeff Wilkins. All those years with the Rams had to put him in position to try a lot of kicks, right?
Yes, it did, and he made a lot of them too, but that's not the right answer for this question. So one more caller is all we can take for today's trivia question about the field goal kicker. Please tell us your answer.
It's Matt Stover.
That is the right answer, and thank you. The underrated Stover, if a kicker can be underrated, that is, booted through 268 field goals in that 10-year span, all for the Cleveland Browns Baltimore Ravens organization. Thanks to all the guessers for the trivia question. Okay, switching gears now. This show is a good forum to debate certain topics. We like to take callers every now and then to see what people are thinking about these days. Let's get right to it with caller number one. Hello, what do you have for us today?
Tony, hey man, thanks for the line, thanks for the time. Listen, what I wanted to talk to you about was the job of an NFL scout. Get your take on how important you think that role is in the grand scheme of things, because I, for one, think it's one of the toughest jobs in football. I mean, probably in all sports, really. So, you're an NFL scout. You have to constantly travel. You're taking meticulous notes. I mean, you are watching every move that these guys make. You got to be extremely observant. It's like they're kind of like a writer in that regard. And, you know, I'm a journalism student, so I can appreciate their attention to detail, Tony. But their job takes constant focus. And I really don't think that's something that can be said for a lot of jobs out there outside maybe the medical profession. But, I wish I knew a scout. You know, I've seen a couple specials where they talk about the role of a scout, but really, I'd like to talk to one personally, you know, to one or two of them, pick their brain, really get in there. I think they'd be really interesting to talk to, you know?
I hear you. Scouts do have a tough job. It's one of those jobs that gets very little recognition, at least in the public eye. Most teams have a pretty good-sized scouting staff, and they take their job seriously. They're the guys out there giving feedback about the future NFL stars. They're the first person who identifies the ones to watch, and they separate the great ones from the rest of the pack. It all kind of starts with them, really. They're the talent evaluators. They bring players to the team's attention. And if it wasn't for scouts, small college players would have little chance of making it to the NFL, or at least even getting drafted. No T.O., no David Patton or Darren Sharper. The list goes on and on. Anyway, we're out of time for this segment. Hey, we appreciate the call. The NFL postseason is awesome. One chance to prove you're the better team. And this week, we'll see what may turn out to be a classic showdown. The Bengals have seen their share of challenges this year, but will face their biggest one to date as they go on the road to take on the Chargers. We're out of time on EA Sports Radio. Good luck to the four remaining teams vying for a spot in the Super Bowl.
So feel free if you want me to have that as its own video from here on out. If not, that's cool too. I figured I'd try it one time. It did take up about 5 minutes of your life, all right? So the starting running back for the NFC side of things is Maurice Jones-Drew. He and two other Falcons made it to the Pro Bowl. Definitely a down year for us. TJ, who's your mama? TJ Hushman's out of championship, Mr. MVP. TJ Who's your MVP? TJ Houshmandzadeh won MVP as a receiver. That's crazy, all right? That is crazy. Is that going to be enough to help the Giants get to the Super Bowl? They did make it to the postseason. You would hope that the MVP at least made it to the playoffs, all right? So the Chargers, we all know that this team has been dominating this franchise. They have been to every single Super Bowl during this franchise. They have beaten us. How many times make the Super Bowl? I think we made it to the Super Bowl. I know we made it at least twice. I got too many freaking series going on, but I know we made it at least twice. Maybe we made it three times. I know for sure twice. And both times the Chargers done beat us. Anyways, man, I'm sick and tired of that happening. Next year we have to get there. I don't care if the Chargers get there or not, but next year I want to get there and get that Super Bowl, and maybe that will be the end of this here series. It's been a good run. This is year six. We're definitely going to do year seven. So wild card round, you got the Patriots falling to the Bengals, the Panthers beating the Packers, the Raiders, they fall to the, though they beat the Texans, excuse me, and the Giants, they advance as well. The Raiders and the Chargers, they battle for the third time this year with the Chargers winning. The Saints, they fall to the Panthers. The Bengals beat the Jets and those G-men over the Seahawks. So we are going to simulate the playoffs, or the conference championship round, I should say. And here we go. The Chargers are going back and they're taking on TJ MVP. And they're also going to be taking on Eli Manning, who they drafted and was like, forget you too, Eli. And now they are going to be meeting in the Super Bowl versus the juggernaut that is those San Diego Chargers, man. The Chargers have Brian Urlacher. At one point in this franchise, they also had the big boss, Randy Moss. Their offense is not as impressive. They no longer have LaDainian Tomlinson. Phillip Rivers moved on a couple of seasons ago. But they still have Carson Palmer. They have the offensive rookie of the year. Imagine that, bro. Not only did the offensive rookie of the year win that award, obviously, it's their running back, Fernandez. He also won running back of the year. That's like having Emmitt Smith retire, and then as soon as he retires, you draft Ezekiel Elliott. There's no gap in between. There's no like 15-year gap. You just pick up right where you left off and have like the best back in the game. That's crazy. But we shut him. That's not we. We are not Giants. We are Falcons in this franchise. But dang, please believe I was kind of rooting for the G-man. Anyways, man, they're going to give that thing to Alexander. And Alexander, he's going to pick up a first down. On the San Diego defensive side of the ball, they got the homie Brian Urlacher, who right on cue makes the tackle right there, rocking number 50. Looking like Junior Seau just a little bit. I know Junior wear 55. I'm just saying, having a great linebacker wearing those colors, this brings back memories is all I'm trying to say. They also have Ed Reed, Bob Sanders. They still have Antonio Cromartie. Ed Reed just made a tackle right there, rocking 46. Their D-line might be the weakest of the bunch because their secondary is scary. Linebacker court is pretty solid. That pass right there is going to be caught by Sonoris Moss, the little boss, and that's going to be a first down. So the Chargers, they've had different pieces come in, but they're still one of the best teams in the league. Eli rolling out. Now he's going to settle in the pocket, throws it, and he throws a pick. You might want to look where you're throwing the football, Eli. That's going to be caught by the homie Ed Reed. Could Ed Reed get another ring? I mean, my goodness gracious, the Chargers, man. Like, when it rains, it pours, and like, just the rich get richer. You know what I mean? When the rains, it pours, usually a term for people that are going through some things. But the rich get richer in this game. But this team has had everybody and their mama who's like a future Hall of Famer. Randy Moss, you know what I'm saying? Phillip Rivers. If Phillip Rivers had this career, no doubt he's a Hall of Famer. He might be considered the best quarterback of all time, right? Anyways, man, the rookie Fernandez, he fumbles the football. We're going to run the... It's not we. I apologize, y'all. Y'all deserve better. Anyways, the Giants, they're going to get the ball back. Throwing a strike over the middle. That's going to be caught for a first down. Going to the right side. That is going to be caught. I believe that's Santonio Holmes, 89. Yes, that is. And now they're going to run the ball again with Alexander. And that is going to be a first down. So first and goal. That's going to get us, not us, Dang it, I apologize, y'all. That's going to get the Giants to the one-yard line, but they fumble the football. Ed Reed recovers it, and the Chargers take back over. They give the ball to little Nate Trimmings. Y'all remember Nate Trimmings? Clearly, the Chargers need to have a running back wearing a 20 number with a dark visor to get to the Super Bowl. Right, Nate Trimmings in real life, LT in this game, and now the homie Josh Fernandez in this game. Jerry Porter makes the catch to end the first quarter. They pick up a first down. Toss play to little Nate Tron. He gets put on his back. Second down in 10 to go up the gut. He's going to run a man over. I see you running hard. That was Jammer. Not Quentin Jammer, but just Jammer. Now they're going to go downtown. That should have been caught by the homie Porter, but he does not hang on to that ball. So breaking the tackle, but then getting brought down quickly is Tony Alexander. Eli Manning throwing it. That's going to be caught by the homie Dudley, and that's a first down, and the G-men are on the move. Can somebody put some points on the board? Ed Reed is not known for dropping passes. That should have been an INT. Instead, they catch a break. The very next pass broken up by Antonio Cromartie, who's rocking 25. So Eli's going to throw the ball for the third straight time, and it's going to be incomplete. Sonoris Moss couldn't hang on to that pass. They give the ball to Fernandez, and Fernandez goes nowhere. They're going to go up that gut. Fernandez gets the carry again, gets brought down by the homie Stanley. Looking downfield after the play, faking that could have been picked, but instead it's just an incompletion. So G-men take over. It's still 0-0. It has been a defense of struggle, defense of slug face. Chris Young gets the tackle right there. Chris Young on the coverage, but TJ, who's your mama, gets the reception for a gain of 8. Now, Alexander gets loose. He's not the fastest guy, but he still gets loose for a nice gain. He's not too fleet of foot, but he got a good game for a first down. Up that gut, and getting chopped down is Tony Alexander Peterson with the takedown. Going downfield, that's going to be broken up by Chris Young. Third down and 9. Eli, do they believe in you, Eli? Don't nobody believe in you, Eli, with the pass like that. First down and 10. Fernandez gets the carry, and Josh Fernandez, he is going to pick up a solid gain, and that's going to be a first down. Going downfield, and that's going to be intercepted by the homie Ross. That's right, Ross is a boss, and that is an interception for the G-men's defense. And now the G-men got this thing going back the other way. What can the Giants do? They're going to give the ball. No, it's a play fake going up top. TJ, that's why you're the MVP. Who's Menzada? Yes, sir. They're going to hurry up to the line of scrimmage. 3 receptions, 38 yards so far for the MVP in this Super Bowl. Offset our formation. Eli looking for TJ. Makes the catch. That's the first points today in this Super Bowl. Touchdown, G-men. And the Giants take a quick 7-0 lead. It really wasn't that quick. It took like the whole first half for somebody to score. They're going to find Antonio Gates makes the catch. Second down and 4. Carson looking downfield. Carson takes a shot deep. Gates is open to the 40, to the 30, to the 20. The rookie Crabtree giving chase. He can't catch him. That's a touchdown for those Chargers. Those San Diego Super Chargers. Carson Palmer sitting pretty in the pocket too. Let that thing fly. And Gates, he done did the rest, man. I hope Gates will do that for us with the Cleveland Browns and my man, those 6 Browns franchise. All right, first down and 10. Eli stepping up in the pocket, letting that thing fly. That's going to be caught, and the G-men are in Chargers territory just like that. Minute on the clock. That should have been an interception, but it's going to fall incomplete. Second down, Eli to the left side. That's going to be caught by Sonoris Moss. Gets brought down after a gain of 9. Going up the gut with Alexander. He's not going to get there. All right, so they got to set up for a field goal. Kick is up, and the kick is no good. So the Giants, they're going to drive all the way downfield not to get any points. The Chargers have 12 seconds on the clock. They're going to take a shot downfield. That's caught by Antonio Gates, and they're in Giants territory. Going downfield again, caught by Porter. They're going to burn a timeout with 5 seconds on the clock. They bring on the field goal team. The kick is up, kick is good. That's a 6-point swing. Instead of being up by 3, the G-men are down by 3. So with 2 seconds on the clock, they're going to squib it. Felipe Buchanan going to take that thing to the crib. Untouched. You squib kick it and you give up a touchdown. Oh my goodness gracious. I know you did not expect that to happen. No. So the New York Giants are up by 14. They're going to get the ball first in the second half. More of the same, just running the ball north and south. Getting busy is Mr. Alexander for a gain of 9. Second down in inches. They're going to give it to him again. Gets brought down by Ed Reba. Picks up a first down. The G-Man going to keep it on the ground again. A big hit in the hole, but he picks up 3. Second down, they're going to give it to Dudley. And Dudley, he's going to pick up a nice gain. So it's going to be 3rd down and 1. Dudley gets the carry again, and that's another first down. The Chargers could be in trouble if they can't stop the ground game. And there goes Brian Urlacher. He has had enough. He's seen enough. 2nd down and 11 to go to the pass. That's going to be caught. The little homie that could. Sonoris Moss with the reception. They're going to go with the ground game, and that gets shut down in a vicious way. 2nd down and 12. They're going to go up that gut, and they get another good gain. Set them 3rd down and short. So on 3rd and 4 from the gun, Eli has it. Over the middle, that's going to be caught by Santana. Not Santana Moss, Santonio. I'm tripping, y'all. Santonio Holmes. Santonio Holmes with the reception. That's going to pick up a first down. Urlacher is still laying haymakers on the running backs. That's going to be caught, but shy of the first down. Marcus, they have to settle for a field goal. This time the kick is up, and this time the kick is good. So San Diego, they take back over. 1st down and 10. Carson Palmer throws it behind the line of scrimmage, and that's going to result in a loss of 3. Play fake. They get a sack on the play fake. The G-men defense is straight hunting. 3rd down and forever. That's going to be caught by Porter, but well shy of the first down marker. Give the ball right back to the G-men. They're going to run the ball with Alexander. He gets popped, but he picks up a gain of 7. Bob Sanders on the tackle. 2nd down and 3. That's going to be broken up, so it's going to be 3rd down now. And on 3rd and 3, Eli dropping back, has a man, but great coverage right there by Antonio Cromartie, batting that thing away. Carson looking downfield, that pass, incomplete. You got to get both feet in bounds. 2nd down and 10, they give the ball to Josh Fernandez. Gets away from one man, but Stanley is there for the tackle. So 17-10 is the score. What can the Chargers do down by 7? 3rd down, Carson under pressure, and he just walks into a sack. The G-Men could maybe put a chokehold on this game by going up 10, but we know no 10-point lead is safe in the Super Bowl. They're going to run the football. Huge hit at the line of scrimmage. Able to pick up 2. Toss play. Alexander gets brought down by the homie Urlacher. 3rd down and 5. Eli looking. Takes a shot deep to the end zone, and that's going to be broken up. Bring on the field goal unit again. The kick is up, and the kick is good. So it's a 10-point game. 20-7 is now the score. Josh Fernandez takes it up the middle, getting north and south for a gain of 5. Palmer dropping back the pass, looks to the left side, and that's going to be caught by Antonio Gates, who just mossed everybody. They're going to give it to Fernandez, gets brought down by Crabtree, and now it's going to be 2nd down and long. And on 2nd down and long, they engaged 8, and that was a mistake. Fernandez down the middle of the field gets the reception for a huge first down, making that number 20 look sweet in the backfield yet again. I remember Nate Tralmeans. I don't care if y'all do or not. That boy was a big man. Big man. Anyways, looking downfield, Carson. That's going to be caught. That's going to be just an inch shy of the first down marker. 3rd down and inches. That's going to be caught. No drop. 4th down. They decide to go for it. They give it to Fernandez, who's not quite as big as Natron means. He ain't got the weight to pick up that inch. And they give the ball back to the G-Men. That could be all she wrote. Can the San Diego Chargers finally lose a Super Bowl? Alexander up that gut gets brought down with the quickness. 3rd down and 4. They give it to the big fullback. And he's not going to get there, but they took some time off the clock. So they pin the Chargers somewhat deep in their own territory at the 35-yard line. That pass falls incomplete. 2nd down and 10. Palmer steps up again. There's only one man down there. Jerry Porter makes the catch. What are the Giants calling? Why would they just not play like man coverage, two man deep as the safeties, and this is not working? That's the fullback that makes the catch. Now they can go to the end zone. That's broken up. 2nd down and goal. That's going to be caught. Huge hit by Jammer, and that pops the ball loose. 3rd down and goal. That's out of the back of the end zone. 4th and goal, they decide to go for the field goal. Kick is up, and the kick is good. 20-13 is the score. They go for the onside kick. They're not going to get it. 1 first down, this thing could be over. They run the ball with the fullback. Going to pick up again a 6. 2nd down and 4. Alexander has enough for a first down, but they say he was inches shy. I would have challenged that thing. On third and inches, they pick it up, and the Chargers are champions no more. It took Eli Manning and TJ, who's your mama, to get it done. No stray hand. No Jason Sehorn. I know he's not even in this game. I'm just saying, though, okay? Okay, no. What's his name? Armstead, I believe. Jesse Armstead. He's not there. We talking about Eli, not even Victor Cruz. My goodness, TJ Houshmandzadeh made y'all lean back like that. Oh, my goodness gracious. No David Tyree. No Justin Tuck. Just Mike Shanahan and Eli Manning with TJ, who's your mama, as the MVP. Gets the Super Bowl. That's crazy. That was crazy. That was a fun game to watch, though. I ain't gonna lie. This is one of the first times that I actually watched the Super Bowl that we did not play. I usually just let it play. Maybe I go do something else, and then I come back, edit it up. This time, I watched that whole second half, and I was like, oh, I actually started watching when Phillip Buchanan, after the Giants missed field goal, when the Giants missed the field goal, I was like, oh my gosh, here come the Chargers. And the Chargers, they drove down the field, they got a field goal. I was like, that's a 6-point swing. And then Felipe Buchanan, that's right, Phillip Buchanan took that thing on a squib kick to the house. And I was like, oh my gosh, the Chargers could be in trouble. Grant Winstrom, he got himself a ring. Albert Haynesworth was on that D-line. He got himself a ring, bruh. Man, what a game. That's all I can say, man. What a flipping game. This is one of the longer episodes because we had the Tony Bruno show. Let me know if you guys want to keep hearing those. I know I'm like the only guys uploading this, so really it's up to you. I'll probably just do this own video, so these videos are not extremely long. But anyways, man, I'm going to get up out of here. And yes, and I'm not a hater. I was rooting for the Giants. I ain't going to lie, the Giants poured it out, so I'm a happy man. But next year, it's the Falcons' turn, baby. I'm gone. Peace, love. Hot sauce.